And thank you for joining us for this Thursday midday webinar workshop where we will be discussing tips and tricks in ScopeAssist. Just so you guys know, we are recording the demonstration part of this. And at the end, I'll open up the floor to any questions and stop the recording. My name is Brian, and we have been having some bi-monthly sessions on various different topics throughout storm season, and we'll continue till about the end of storm season. Again, I have muted everyone just so I can get through the presentation portion. If you do have any questions, you can either type it into the chat on screen or just write them down, and I'll try my best to answer them at the end of this webinar. Some of this might be review for you, other things might be new. I'm going to start in ScopeAssist, and then I'm going to show a couple of things in ExactMe, and then finish up with just some other products that can be useful and help you with your workflow. So the first thing I want to go over, something we get questions about often, is validation issues. The validation issues are anything you see in red. So over here, you see your roofing material in red. If you try submitting the job right now, you'll get a nice pop-up message saying validation issues. Correct the issues before submitting. That means a required field in the application has not been filled out yet. And we are currently working on it, so the red is a little bit more robust when you're out in direct sunlight. We understand right now the red is not the best with the contrast of the sun. Let me go in and fix this issue. So you see all of this stuff up here in red. These are all required. So for a house, it's west. So 30-year laminate, 10% waste, and same as primary. So this one does have a low facet, which will automatically populate from the CAD report. Also, at times, when you try to submit, you'll get this other message saying CAD not used, proceed without using CAD. That means the CAD, the full 3D CAD has come in, it's just not fully attached to the job yet. This usually happens when you're in the job as the CAD comes back in from Eagle View. What you have to do is just go to the form overview and down to the bottom left and hit apply CAD. So this section in the bottom left should always say remove CAD. And then if I went and hit submit job, it would let me with no other issues. Also, just as a note, get back into this, the structures button. The structures only are relevant when you have a multi-structure property. It's just an easy way to switch between the two. It also lets you know which structure you're in. Right now, I am in the red structure, which is the primary structure. I want to go to the secondary. I'd hit go to this job, and I would go over to the secondary structure. Now, before I go over to ExactMe and show a couple of different things over there, when we send a password reset to you guys, or when you try to do a password reset yourselves, that link that you get does expire after 1 hour. So after 1 hour, you're going to have to either give us a call to send you a new link or request a new link to be able to reset your password. Now in ExactMe, let's log in. There's some handy tips and tricks in here too. Sometimes it takes a moment for it to load, but this happens a lot. In rare cases, the exact analysis communications box, this box down here, will disappear from your view. I've seen it a couple times since I've been working here, and it's easy to get it back. All you have to go to is ExactMate, Options, and then make sure the view is status bar and exact analysis are clicked. You can also hit Reset Dashboard View and Reset Project Views. It just resets the view. It does not actually alter anything else besides the views and goes back to the default views. There are, in several places in ExactMate, there is handy search features. For example, down here, there is one, which, let's say I search for hail. It will bring up every project with the word hail in it. It's just easier, especially when you have multiple pages, to find the job you're looking for. Again, there's another search box up here in the recent projects, which will allow the same kind of functionality. Just a note up here that this section is just your most recent projects. After a while, they do go over to your just projects tab. And for some of you guys, this page is going to be completely full of jobs. Again, there's the search bar up here. And if you are sharing a view with other users in your specific company, you can do show all, and then you'll be able to search your jobs much easier for all the jobs in the company. So if you're looking for something specific, this is the way to find it. ExactMate also has a help section, which is very robust and has a lot of useful information in this section. What I want to point your attention to is the 24/7 online support. So if you click on that, it pops up another window. And just go on over to this. It's where you get the online 24/7 support. It also allows for you to ask a question. It has helpful links and tricks. It also has a live help. The live help is where you can interact with an ExactMate person. So let's say you want to set up some macros or you have a very specific detailed question. This is the resource that's probably going to be the most useful to go to. That you can also call. But I want to just bring your attention to a telephone support fee may apply if you do give them a call, which is why we tend to recommend doing their online support, which is free. And again, that is by going to ExactMate, then help, and 24/7 online support. Lastly, there are a bunch of different cases, tools, and things that just help you on the roof itself. Personally, I'm a huge fan of OtterBoxes. They're very rugged, they're very robust, and they will protect your phone. At a previous job, I one time put an iPhone 4 into an OtterBox case, chucked against the wall. The iPhone is completely fine, the wall, not so much. The wall is kind of damaged, but again, the phone had all its functionality. Also on the roof, I understand that you're up there juggling a notepad, your phone, everything else that you need. They do have nifty products like this that will allow for you to actually slip your fingers through something so you're not going to drop your phone. And this one's for an iPhone. They also have one that's like this that is not phone specific, that just straps on through elastic. Again, it can be very helpful for just holding onto the phone while you're on the roof. And going off through that similar vein, that you can get different kind of utility belts that can clip onto your belt, or you get a specific belt for this that could hold your pen, your cell phone, paper, whatever else you need, which is just extremely useful so you're not dropping things, especially when you're on that ladder. Again, like if it's a high roof, you don't want to be fumbling while you're going up the roof. With these products, you got to go for what's best for you. This one, for example, straps around the neck. It's just different things for different people that got to go for what helps you the best. That about wraps up my presentation. I'm going to stop the recording and open up the floor for any questions about tips or tricks or anything for ScopeAssist in general, or if you want me to review anything else. Thank you so much for joining us, and I hope you guys have a great day.